trying to argue that governmental action is not forceful, Senator Harry Reid claimed that income taxes are voluntary. If the government is in the business of forcefully taking money from some people in order to provide welfare benefits to others, how will the people whose money is being taken feel about the government?
Well, I don't accept your phraseology. I don't think we force people.
Taxation is not forceful?
Well, no.
It's voluntary?
In fact, quite to the contrary. Our system of government is a voluntary tax system.
Oh, if you don't want to pay your taxes, you don't have to?
Well, of course you have to pay your taxes. But
well, the government will force you to pay, or they'll fine you or imprison you.
We have a voluntary system. The fact of the matter is that if when you pay your taxes, you see, in many other countries, it's not voluntary. For example, in many countries, the government makes sure that your employer takes out every penny. In many countries, don't file income tax returns.
We have withholding here too, don't we?
Pardon me?
Withholding?
With some programs, yes. But I'm talking about in some countries, European countries as an example, there you don't file an income tax return. There is no need to, because your employer takes all the money out. That's the difference between a voluntary and an involuntary system. You can't cheat and not pay your taxes.
Right.
But I don't accept your phraseology that you forcibly take money from somebody else and give it to you know, that's the way it is. On any program, highway program is the same. We take money, we forcibly take money in your phraseology,
but
from people and
let me
build
ask you
highways
this question.
With it. Put people in the army.
Can the taxpayer decide not to pay his taxes if he wants?
He can not pay his tax he wants.
What will happen?
He's subject to civil and criminal penalties.
They'll put him in jail. They use force against him. Everybody pays taxes under threat of jail or fine, under threat of force. In other words, you are forced to pay your taxes. Whether you fill out your form voluntarily or whether it's withheld by your employer, you don't have a choice on whether you can pay taxes that are going to be used for welfare programs. You can't make that choice.
Well, but the reason our system is called a voluntary tax system, and I recognize, you know, that ultimately you can't cheat in your taxes, but we have many provisions in the law they don't have in most countries. We have deductibility for home, interest on mortgage payment. They don't have that in most countries. We have deductibility for certain excessive expenses as it relates to health, doctors, hospitals. We have all kinds of tax, some people call them loopholes, but others would call them incentives for people to do business. And that's why you're not forced to pay certain taxes. There are ways. If you decide to buy a home,
you can decide not to pay taxes in the United States?
I mean, I really don't understand what you're trying to get at. The point of the matter
because
is...
Because you objected to my phraseology. You say that the government isn't forcefully taking money from some people to provide welfare benefits to others. And in fact, that's what it's doing, because all taxation is forceful. It's backed up by physical force. If you don't pay your taxes, the government will intervene with you forcefully. So you don't have a choice. It's not voluntary. You can't decide not to pay and not suffer a consequence. If you don't pay, you'll go to jail.
Well, you're forced to pay.
You don't
go to jail. Some people go to jail. There are all kinds of civil penalties. If you don't pay your taxes, you pay interest and you pay penalties. The fact of the matter is, our system is a voluntary system.